My research is understanding why species have different types of horns.
When it comes to something like an animal weapon, what we want to know is why one species of beetle, for example, or you could apply the same logic to antlers, in why does a mule deer antler differ from a white-tailed deer, and why is that different from an elk or a caribou? The antlers are totally different. They're weapons. They're in males. Males use them to fight with other males. They're doing the same kind of thing. So why does one species have one kind of weapon and another have another? These are fundamental questions at the heart of animal diversity.
I've gotten really good at measuring beetles. So I've looked at mechanical properties of horns, so how likely the horns are to break, what sort of forces the horns experience during fights. And most recently, the paper that's just coming out in PNAS is using engineering tools and specifically biomechanical modeling to figure out the specific stresses and strains that a horn experiences in a fight to understand why we see the different types of morphologies that we do.
The thing that's hard is what you want to know is whether a mule deer with a mule deer kind of antler does better at its own kind of fights than a white-tailed deer's antler would. I mean, does that difference in shape matter? And the only way to test it is to get an animal with one kind of weapon to fight against or to experience forces and strains in a fight the way that another species of animal would fight. And you can't get them to do that in the wild. They don't cooperate. You can't get a white-tailed deer to fight the way a caribou fights. And so there is no way in the field to test whether one kind of weapon performs better at one style of fighting than it does at another style of fighting. Can't do it. But with engineering technology, you can do it.
These weapons, these animal weapons, are really charismatic. They're big, they're diverse. And I think the same findings in rhinoceros beetles apply to other types of animal weapons. So beetles have different types of horns because they're used in different ways. And I think the horns and antlers of ungulates also have different types of shapes because they're used in different ways. So I think my research more broadly shed some light on the diversity of animal weapons and biological structures.